In this video, we'll try to understand how to find out the equation of motion and hence the frequency of vibration of a spring mass system as shown in the figure. M is the mass which will be displaced in the downward direction and whose frequency of vibration we have to find out. Capital M is the mass of this particular disc around which this mass is wrapped around. K is the stiffness of the spring and the motion is in the downward direction. So if this mass is displaced in the downward direction, then what will happen? That we have to see. Suppose the mass is displaced in this downward direction, then there will be an elongation of the spring of stiffness x. So the mass will start, this mass will start oscillating in this particular direction about the mean equilibrium position. So there will be a linear kinetic energy of this particular mass. Then the rotation of this drum, there are oscillations of this drum, and there will be a rotational kinetic energy of the disk of mass M, capital M. Then there will be an elongation of this, elongation and contraction of the spring. So there will be a strain energy that will be stored in this spring whose stiffness is K. So there are three types of energies which we have analyzed over here. That is the linear kinetic energy of mass M, small m, which is displaced. Then oscillation and therefore rotational kinetic energy of the disk of mass capital M, and there will be elongation and contraction of the spring, and therefore the strain energy that will be stored because of this elongation and contraction in the spring whose stiffness is K. Now suppose the initial position is over here, that is at A, and when the mass is displaced in the downward direction, the point A will get displaced to A dash. So we can say that this distance x, the relation between this distance x and this angular distance can also be written like this. So A is moved to A dash, then x is the distance which is displaced, correct, in the downward direction. The same will be the rotation over here also. So we can say that x is equal to r theta. So r is the radius of the drum and theta is the angular displacement and x is the linear displacement of the mass. So approximately we can say that x is equal to r theta. So first derivative of this displacement is the velocity. R is constant, so it is theta dot. So theta dot is nothing but angular velocity in radian per second. Second derivative is x double dot, that is r theta double dot. Theta double dot is nothing but the angular acceleration in radian per second square. Now let us say that E is equal to total energy possessed by the system. Then we know that it is equal to translational or linear kinetic energy of the mass M plus a rotational kinetic energy of the disk of mass M that we have seen, and strain energy stored by the spring due to elongation and contraction whose stiffness is K. So using this, we'll start with the derivation of the frequency of vibration of the given particular spring mass system. So we can say that translational kinetic energy of the mass M is 1/2 mv square. Rotational kinetic energy is 1/2 I omega square. And we know that mass moment of inertia, this formula we have directly taken from physics, that is mr square by 2. So that value also we can substitute afterwards. And strain energy already we have derived, it is 1/2 kx square. Now let us start with our derivation part over here. So as we have seen, the three equations which we have already written is that linear or translational kinetic energy of the mass M is 1/2 mv square, rotational kinetic energy of the disk is 1/2 I omega square, and strain energy of the spring is 1/2 kx square. Now in place of velocity, we can substitute x dot. In place of omega, we can substitute theta dot plus 1/2 k. And in place of x, we can substitute r theta and square of that. So this is 1/2. Now in place of x dot also, we can write down it is as r theta dot and square of that. So this is, so all the terms will be in terms of theta or theta dot. 1/2 I into, now value of I that we have seen is mr square by 2 for the circular disk, plus 1/2 into k r square theta square. So this is the equation of motion that we have obtained in this particular case. So let us further simplify this. So it is 1 half mr square theta dot square plus, we can say that it is mr square by 4 theta dot square. So here it should be theta dot square plus 1 half kr square theta square. So this is our first equation, and this equation is known as the equation of motion. Now we know that total energy of the system remains constant. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but will get transferred from one form to another form. So derivative of this particular constant term, that is E, will be zero. So we'll differentiate both the sides with respect to time t, and then this will be equal to 1 half m is constant, r square is constant, so it is derivative of theta dot square, plus mr square by 4, and here we are already having theta dot square, so that we have seen that we have forgot to return to that particular term, so it is mr square by 4 derivative of theta dot square plus 1 half kr square into derivative of theta square. So we have seen that as the value of energy is constant, its derivative will be zero. So 1 half mr square as it is. Now derivative of theta dot square, correct, that is nothing but 2 theta dot, and again derivative of theta dot with respect to time, so that is theta double dot by chain rule of the derivative. So this is mr square by 4, again derivative of theta dot square is 2 theta dot, and again derivative of theta dot, that is theta double dot, plus 1 half kr square. Derivative of theta square is 2 theta, and again derivative of theta with respect to time, that is theta dot. So again we have used the chain rule over here of the derivative. Now we can say that we can cancel out certain terms over here. So 2 will get cancelled out. Here also it will be 2 that will remain in the denominator, and here also 2 will get cancelled out from the numerator as well as from the denominator. So the equation that we are having is, so if you take theta dot common, then the equation that we'll get is mr square theta double dot plus mr square by 2 theta double dot plus kr square theta. So this is the equation that will remain over here. So 0 upon theta dot, that term will get cancelled out. So we are having mr square theta double dot plus mr square by 2 theta double dot. Plus kr square theta is equal to 0. Now we can take theta double dot common from both these terms, first two terms, that is these two terms. So it is mr square plus mr square by 2 theta double dot plus kr square theta is equal to 0. Now divide throughout by this term, so that we'll have theta double dot, you know, as our first term. So it is theta double dot plus kr square divided by the given particular term, that is mr square plus mr square by 2 into theta. And that is equal to 0. Now r square is common from the numerator as well as from the denominator. So this r square will get cancelled out from the numerator as well as denominator. So we can say that, so if you take r square common from the denominator, it is m plus m by 2 into theta is equal to 0. So we can cancel out this r square from the numerator as well as denominator. So ultimately we are left with the equation of theta double dot plus k upon m plus m by 2 into theta. So let us write down that particular equation. And now we have to compare this equation with the equation of simple harmonic motion, because the motion of the given particular system is simple harmonic motion. The motion which is repeated after a regular interval of time is known as a simple harmonic motion. So if you compare this equation with the equation of simple harmonic motion, then the equation which we have already derived is theta double dot plus omega square theta is equal to 0. So omega square is nothing but k upon m plus m by 2. So taking square root on both the sides, so we can say that omega will be equal to square root of k upon m plus m by 2. Now in place of omega, we can substitute 2 pi f, that is 2 pi into frequency, and then we can find out the frequency in hertz for this particular arrangement. So this is square root of k upon m plus m by 2. So frequency of oscillation or frequency of vibration of the given particular spring mass system is given by 1 upon 2 pi square root of k upon m plus m by 2 in hertz or oscillations per second or vibrations per second. So in this way we can derive the expression of the frequency of vibration for the given spring mass system. Thank you very much for watching.